Welsh pups were expected to be born on the 24th of May 2006, so the pups would be only 2 to 3 weeks apart and good company for each other, in theory anyway. Len wanted to train the Airedale as his helper dog, and I was going to train the Welsh pup in obedience and agility, along with Mr. Mac. I thought Mr. Mac would be happy with this plan, as he was used to being a pack dog at the breeder's home, and he desperately wanted a doggy friend to play with. He was positively clueless when it came to playing with toys or humans. Still, being in a state of shock, I couldn't even decide whether it was me or Len who'd made the decision to buy both pups. I'm not sure why I did agree to it, but I did. And I was more than a little excited about the new arrivals. It could only have been the sight of the puppies at training school that had melted my resolve like ice cream on a hot day. My thoughts were laden with all sorts of scenarios. Annie likes Welsh rarebit. What's to say she wouldn't wonder whether a bit of Welsh terrier would taste just as good? How long would it be before Mr. Mac started wanting to play chase? How many pairs of slippers did I need to keep on standby? I already thought raising Mr. Mac was hard work, and he was 2.5 years old. He was a piece of cake compared to our first night with a 9-week-old pup. If people ever wondered why they should pick a mature rescue rather than a pup, I suggest that they ask me. I shall tell them more than a tale or two. Introduction. A bit of background. McKeon joined us in December 1995. A bold little pup that had made the journey from Belfast to Luton by plane. 2 weeks later, Annie joined us, making the same trip. But that did not go quite as smoothly, and the airline lost her for several hours. She was called Annie because by the time we got her, she was like a little lost soul crying for her mum, a warm meal and a cuddle.